Alright, this is a slow project, but somebody's got to do it. Just keep wetting it. And it gets so soft. Unfortunately, I had to wait till it gets up in the 90s to do this. Then I'll just keep wetting it and keep going down. Go down about 3.5 feet. Then I can wobble it and I can level it. Put my level on there and level it. Okay, I see what happened here. Reason this ain't wanting level. I think somebody gave me a dish several years back, and I got in a hurry. Just dug a little hole, set it down in the hole, and filled it in. And even though it was level, let it sit for a week. It got out of level over time, and I can move it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to dig down a little more. Bring my level out here, level it, get it nice and plumb level. Brace it all the way around. Take that concrete and just fill it in, pour it all the way around. Now this time I'm gonna pour it all the way level here, all the way around, and that thing won't move. Then I can start working on that dish. Okay, got a pretty level. All the way around here. Dug it out, wobbled it around, got it pretty level here. Got my level on here. Right here. Right there. There, so we're good all the way around. Oh yeah. So next step, see, I kind of propped it up all the way around, kind of wobbled it out, wet it good down there so the concrete will run down in the hole. And all I got to do now, see, I got my hole with the concrete just run right down in the hole. All I got to do now, go start mixing my concrete up. Fill her up and let her set for about a week. Move this clothesline out of the way. Prepare my dish up and set it on the pole. I should be good. I should be good to go then. Okay. Mixing my concrete up. I'm making sure it's good mix. Good mix here. What I do, go all the way around. Take a scoop of this and get it all good and mixed. Drop it in there like so. Kind of just vibrate it down in there. That's that way that thing will stay good and level. Everything sink right in. Just keep right on doing it until I get it all the way up to the top and I'll be good. Okay, continuing on this. Got it nice and plumb and level, looks good. I've been sitting about a week. I went ahead and wire brushed all that, spray painted, and looked nice and neat. I got this one set. I'm thinking I got that, that's gonna be sitting south there. I would assume back in the day they had this on the old G3 satellite at 95 west back in the day. That's where I assume where it is right there. So what I'll do when I get it all together and get the dish on, I'll do a scan and I'll find out. But on these, the toughest part of this whole thing is redoing all this. With these were so frozen
You'd think they'd break off, but look at them now. Very smooth. With this, you don't want to break these. Because if you do, look how clean that is in there. If you do, you're asking for more trouble. So even though it act like it don't want to move, you get you some penetrating oil. Like I got over there, you squirt it and just let it soak, and you take your wrench and just kind of just keep going. Yeah, I mean, it might take your wrench, you know, and if it's tightened up real tight in there, I even got some dirt up in that thing. But it's no big, it'll work out. When I first got this thing, them things were so froze up and so corroded up. Get you a little bit of this stuff here. Well, this one here's broke. And what you do, you squirt a little bit around the threads there. You can't hardly get into there, so you just get as close as you can and just take your wrench and just kind of just try to break it. Go back and forth, back, just keep right on doing it, working it in. And what I usually do, instead of doing it like that, because you end up breaking it, I keep just working to try to get it out of there. And you work it out, keep squirting. It might take you 30 minutes to get that thing out of there. Just keep doing it. Sooner or later, you can do it with your hand. Just keep working once you get it all out. You know it's tight in there, so take it and stick it in there, squirt it all in there, let her soak. And as time goes, let it soak 15, 20 minutes and work its way in. Of course, with this off, the old one off, just work it all the way in and you can eventually get it where you can just, well, I got this on now. You can eventually just bury it. I mean, it'll work its way out and just keep working it out till it sticks out about that far on the inside. Bottom it out all the way. Then you're good. Eventually you can get them all hand tight and just screw them all out. And what I do, clean it off good, try to get all the crud off of it. What I do, I flip this upside down and I go ahead and get it all the way in as far as I can go. Clean it off good. Shoot it with some spray paint around there. Get the bottom side of it. Then flip it back over. And if you got any excess penetrating oil, just let it drain out. Let it drain out for a half hour and take your rag, wipe it out and get it all cleaned up. The penetrating oil actually help clean this thing up. Then start spray painting. Then everything will look good. You might have a half decent dish, it might look new by the time you get it all done. Well, I'm gonna continue on with this later. Okay, I got this all spray painted up. Close to ready to mount. Looks good. Looks almost new. But it ain't new, but then what I need to do next is take this mess off, get it all cleaned up, and mount this. Get this all mounted, put me a new LNBF on there. Take this stuff here. This don't work. Take it, throw it in the garbage, and put that new LNBF on. Mount it onto that. If I do that, I can mount it onto the dish, and then I can line it up. What I'll probably do is go ahead and take that one down off that, take that box down. And what I'll do next is start on that one, take it apart, and put it on there. Then I'll get my mount on there, and I'll synchronize all three of these together and put me a switch on there and go ahead and hook it up to a box. But of course, I'll line every one of them up, you know, and get everything good to go. Probably have that far one. I'll probably have it on 91 west. I'll probably put that middle one right there. Whenever I put a big dish on there, I'll probably have it pointed toward Galaxy, probably G19. And on this one here, I'll probably just set it on SES-1 MeTV satellite. And of course, that one over there, I'll just do whatever with that. And that's what I'm gonna do now. Go ahead and get this thing mounted, take this mess off, and get this mounted.
Okay. I went on ahead and decided to do this first, put the dish up first, because the feed assembly, trying to put that thing up on the ground is just a pain, so I'd fare better doing it like this, because I got me like a 16-foot ladder, and I can go from the back and have somebody hold it, and I can, maybe a lot easier. Believe me, it'd be a lot easier just put the dish on there and do the feed assembly later. But other than that, this thing here is looking pretty new. I believe this is a 6-footer because the feed assembly's got 3 arms on it instead of 4, so I'd assume this is a 6-footer. Put one here, put one there, and put one down here and go right there. About 36 inches, 36 to 37 out, and adjust my feed, and we should be good to go on that. I had to straighten them old arms out with a vice grip up there with the vise. I had to straighten them arms out a little bit, and I'll probably put my feed assembly on there later. We're fixing to get the rainstorms. I'm going to put this on pause and probably do this later.
Okay, I'm back on this dish. I'm fixing to put this L&B assembly on here. I'm trying to get, these things are all bent out of shape, so I'm having to straighten them out. And the key, first off, before I even did all this mess, have me an imaginary, well, most of these dishes got holes right here in the center, so you can actually, you know, see if you're going to see the, it's going to kind of go up here, so I'll be fine up here on the arc. But man, this is going to be mostly stationary anyway. It's going to be back up this way, so I should be fine. But the main thing, the center of this has got to be dead center in the center of this. I'm just using this as a reference. This ain't what to use, but this is all I got right now. This needs to be dead center of that, so what I need to do is move this over back to the right a little bit, but I'm gonna bring that right there in, so that should pull it back, and that's got the center of that. We should be good. And like I say, I'm just using this as a reference. Here to here, and basically from here to here, just like that, all the way around. Make sure it's dead center, and it should be good. But like I say, I got that straightened out. That looks pretty good, and I got that one looking good. And this here is going to go right here, pull back this way, and that'll pull this over just a little bit. And I get it about right there, I'll be fine. So that's going to go right there, but I'm going to have to straighten this out, pull it back this way, and pull that back out, and tighten her down, and should be fine. Put my L&BF on there, then I'll go do a scan tomorrow. I should be fine. Okay, I'm back on this. This is actually a crude way to do it, but this is how I do it. I go right here to here. Make sure this one here is going to sit flush there. That one's going to sit flush there. I mean, I don't. But I mean, basically, let me do this again. Okay, I'm back on this. So I got this all tightened down good. I think I got it pretty well center, pretty dead center. What I'll usually do, I kind of make sure this thing is sitting pretty good. It's pretty much there. What I usually do, if that's going to sit flush like that, that means this one's going to be like this, and this one's going to be like this, and this one's going to be like this. With no pressure on it. I mean, it just sits perfect. So I think that's pretty good. We're looking real good there. So I'll go ahead and get this one here next. Then I'll throw all my LMDs on here, and I'll put that other one back on there, then I'll line these things up tomorrow. All right, talk to you in a little bit. Okay, back on this dish here. I'm gonna go ahead and this thing is froze, so I decided to go ahead and just take this off. I'm just gonna put me a bar on here. We got the holes in it. Then I'm gonna line up what I wanna line up. Probably just gonna put this on Galaxy 16, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that and line this thing up, put me an LMB in there, and probably set this on Galaxy 16 or G19. I ain't figured it out. Probably put one on one or the other. But I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. Set this thing up, pull this off, put me that arm on there. Alright, first step, cut this off, saws off. Froze up. Like I had this on here when I put it up. Apparently I did. Never took it off, so I'm gonna cut this off, the saws off. Cut that top bolt off. Cut that top bolt off there and it should fall right off. Alright. Got that one cut. Got that one cut. I'm gonna take me a hammer or a pipe wrench, just knock it loose. Got it loose. Alright, let it down. We'll knock this other out right here. Take this and pull this thing off, and I'll put my bar on there. Alright. Got that off. Got my bar on there. Now I'm just going to take that thing and just throw it in the junk pile. It's no good. And I'm going to put the LMB on there. Put my TV and signal meter on there and move this thing around, see if I can find a signal. All right, got my LMB on there. Got my trusting cheap meter up on there, works fine. Thing's about 15, 20 years old. Used it back in the old days, still works. And I got my receiver hooked up. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna lower this down. And I barely hear a little beep, blink noise. And I'm ready to go ahead and search for my signal. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and search my signal. First thing I do, I done pull the screws off here. Pull this out. Kind of just maneuver this thing back and forth. You'll hear it go, you'll see it go up. You hear it? Dead on already. All I did was just line this one up with that one. Perfect. So you'll see my meter go up and down. Here we are. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna lower this meter. All right, I pulled this off. Now I'm ready to find my signal. It's already there. Cause I lined this one up with this one there. It's pretty good. You see my jump meter jumping up and down as I move this back and forth. We're probably sitting at, all right, I'm moving this. You see my meter jumping up and down? So I'm gonna lower this volume a little bit, this meter a little bit, kind of zero in. And I'm thinking this one probably sitting at 113 for already. So I'm gonna increase the meter, lock this down, and see what I got. I'm gonna go ahead and hook this TV up. Turn this on. I ain't got my receiver on yet. Go ahead and turn it on. Actually, the receiver is turned on because the meter's not going to work without the receiver turned on. I just hadn't turned the TV on, but I'm pretty confident I got it locked. Probably on 105, considering where those other ones are pointed. So I'm going to go ahead and do a scan, turn the TV on and do a scan. All right, got a good signal on here. I'm going through the satellites here. That old thing, that meter's gonna jump up and down as I go through it. As I go through, I notice I don't have 105 on here. I'm just guessing, 105 west. So I'm gonna put 105 west in this, in here, because I don't think I have it in here. Thing about these GT Media receivers, you gotta put the satellites in there. I don't have 105 west in here. I'm guessing it's 105. If it's not, it's not. It'll come up, whatever comes up. I'm gonna put 105 west in here and do a scan and see what I get. All right, I'm gonna do my scan. If I happen to be on 105 west, what I might be, I may not be. But since there's not a lot of free stuff on it, I go ahead and hit no. That way I can just see if I'm on the right satellite. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit search. And I'm gonna wait a few minutes and see if I get anything. May not get nothing. Might be a false reading. Sometimes this thing will give false readings, but I'm pretty confident I'm on something. Let's see what happens here. I should tell right off the bat if I'm on the right thing. Unfortunately, it's doing the same thing. This thing's so sensitive it jumped back to 103, but I guess it don't matter. It might be on 103. But I was shooting for 105, but we'll see what happens here. Let's see what happens. I'm gonna go ahead and pause this. Something comes, there it goes, I'm getting something on there. Says for, oh yeah. I'm guessing 105. Of course I could be wrong. We'll see. Now these are all pay channels because I put all them in there. I just wanna see what's on here. No, I'm on the Mexico one. I'm on 113 west. I'm a little bit off. I can tell that right now. I might leave it on there, but there ain't nothing on there but Spanish channel, so I guess I'm gonna go ahead and move this thing on up. I'm gonna go ahead and delete all this out and move this dish over. Well, that's how you gotta do it. Just kind of play around. It ain't gonna really matter if your satellite is, if you got the right stuff in there. You can just make up a satellite and put it in there just to do a scan, as long as you got your frequencies right. That receiver don't know no different. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete all this out and move this over and look for either G16 or 105 or whatever. I'll talk to you later. Okay, I went in my menu. Since this thing was piggybacking on 103 west and it had that in there, I went on ahead and deleted all them channels out of there, one by one. It was on that Mexican satellite, 113 west. So I figured, well, since I'm on here, I'm gonna go ahead and just put that in here. All right, got 113 west typed in here. Got the correct satellite in there, so I figured I'd go ahead and put this in there. This is the Mexican satellite, so I'm gonna go ahead and get out of this. And you see, I see what it did. It jumped back over to 103. I don't know what happened here, but I'm gonna put it back in. I think I didn't hit save or something, so I'm gonna go back in and do it again. Then I'm gonna go ahead and do my scan on 113. So you gotta kind of be careful on these sensitive boxes. They don't wanna work right. It'll jump from one to the other. That's what it did a while ago. So I'm gonna go ahead and go back in there, put it all back in there, and find out what I did wrong, and put 113 in here and go ahead and do a scan. Well, the reason I was screwing up, I forgot about these GT Media boxes. Well, not only they'll have all them Eastern satellites in there, but they already have the 113 already in there, I noticed. So what I was doing, I was trying to overwrite, and it kept messing up, so it was already in there, and I had a check mark. That's probably another reason it wouldn't work right. So I'm gonna try this again. It's already in there, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a scan. I'm gonna put the 113 in there. Once this in there, then I'm gonna go ahead and move it on over and see what else I can get it on. See what all I can get. I might just put it on G16 or 105. It's not critical. I got a bunch of these dishes. I might just put this on 105 and leave it, or a Galaxy 16 and leave it. One of those two. I'm gonna go ahead and do a scan. All right, I got them scanning. I get about 12 channels, so I'm just gonna go ahead and leave, and I'm gonna go ahead and move this on over to the next satellite. Alright, I'm guessing 105 west. That's what I put in here. Nope, 103 west. I'm going to clean these out and back it up a little bit, try to get 105 on there. That's what you have to do. You just kind of play around with it. I know I'm scanning in 103 west, so I'm just going to just back it up just a tad, and I'm going to do another scan. I'm going to clean these out and go back. I'm going to clear all these out and do another scan on 105 west. So we know this is 103 west, because that's got them shopping home channels. So I'm going to go ahead and clean all this out, clear all this out, and kind of ease that back that way just a tad, and do another scan. It should be there, because I'm going to go ahead and put 105 on here and lock it down. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. Okay, it's me again. I'm still on 103 west on these bars here. What I usually do, there's two holes in here. You got one here and you got one here. What I'll do is I'll lower this here and put it in this hole here. And I will either leave it for this hole here or to go to this hole here. And believe it or not, it'll actually line up, because I can stick this in this hole here. Leave this one, either put this one in this hole or kind of swap it around, and it will line up. Just takes a little plate, and I'll make my adjustments here if I have to. But I'm gonna go ahead and just lock this on 105 west. I'm on 103 now. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this out and just kind of bump this over. And usually what I'll do, I'll get a picture on 103 and kind of ease it over. And when I lose the picture, that's when I lock it down, because we're talking about 2 degrees spacing. And usually that should do it. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now, but I'm gonna do it off camera. So basically, when you lose the picture, once that picture goes away, you see where you're at, and that's where you want to lock it down and do a scan. So that's what I'm going to do on 105. I'm going to set this up again and delete all them channels back out of there. And, actually, it's on 105, so I'm going to delete those out already. Just delete those out, and I'm going to go ahead and just move this over and do another scan on 105 west. All right, that's me again. So I lost my picture, and what I did, I got so much gap here. When I stuck it back in this hole, I went over a little too far. So how you correct that? See, I know I need to go back this way. So what I'll do is I'll loosen these screws here and just kind of bump it back this way. Then my signal should come back. And I'm going to go ahead and just do that off camera. All right, I had to put some lubricant on here. Some WD-40 to loosen these up and make these adjustments. And that should bring this, peek this back out, and we should be fine. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to rotate it, see if I can get it, peek it out, and I'm going to lock it down. I'm going to do another scan. We got 39% quality, so pretty much it, probably, I think. 90 signal, so if I just do my little adjustments here, it should peak it, and I'll do another scan. All right, now we're doing a scan on 105 west. We're starting to pick something up. I'm scanning all these pay channels, so I'm not going to get those, but should bump them radio stations up. So once that's done, then I'm gonna go ahead and just leave this on here and just leave this where it's at, because I noticed there's a few. It says syndication, looks like it's scrambling, but unfortunately it didn't work. I'm a little lost on here because I didn't scan anything in, so I'm gonna try this again. All right, another goof. I seen that CBS come up, and I seen Tune and all this other stuff. So I just scanned in 107 west, and I just barely bumped it. So I'm going to go bring it on back down. Don't take much, so I'm going to delete all these out. I scanned in 107 west. There ain't nothing encrypted programming on there. That's it. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this back out of there. And I'm going to bump it over, and I'm going to see if I can try 105 again, 105 west. All right, this thing is scanning in 103 again. It's either 103 or 107. What it is, this dish is so small, you got to be dead on it. You're getting interference spillover from either 107 or 103. It's kind of hard to get a lock on 105 because this thing is so small. This is the smallest dish I got. This thing is measured out probably 5.5-6 foot. So that's part of the problem right there. Too small is not good. I don't care if it's a KU or a C-band. This thing is so small, and it's so hot out here, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this video up. You got the idea. Just kind of just keep playing with it. You pull your L&B in and out a little bit. It's pretty well maxed out at 74%.
But still, this ditch is just too small. I'm getting spillover from 107, and I'm also getting spillover from 103. I remember back in the 80s and 90s, that was very common with these small dishes. You get bleed over from adjusting satellites. Well, back in the day, you'd see two pictures because it was analog. One would spill over in the other with these small dishes. I think that's what's happening here. One's canceling the other out. You can't get 105 locked on this thing because of 107 and 103. 2 degrees spacing, and it seemed like 107 and very strong satellite 107, and so is 103. So it's 105 is gonna be hard to get with this small dish. I'm only mostly wanting to get it for radio stations, but right now I'm just scanning in 103. So I'm just gonna just close this video out. You get the idea how to do this stuff. It's very sensitive. Just kind of play around with it, you'll get it. But I'm gonna do this for another day. I think I can still get 105 on this thing. I just kind of keep playing with it. I just want to get the radio stations on here. There's about 800 radio stations. You can pick them up with a small dish, but you got to have it so precise. So I'm going to do this on another day. But like I say, you got the idea how this works. So it's nothing but a hobby. So I'm going to go ahead and close this out. You get the idea. I'll talk to you later.